Over the past few decades, China has been finding ways to build transport links in its remote regions. And in the breathtaking mountains and canyons of the southwest, they needed an extreme solution. Eight of the world's 10 highest bridges are in China, and several of them are here in this region. The newest and most impressive has to be this one, Beipanjiang Bridge. It's the highest bridge in the world, connecting the two provinces of Guizhou and Yunnan. A dizzying 565 metres from the bridge to the river below, it can fit New York's Empire State Building underneath with over 100 metres to spare. I was lucky to visit just before it opened. Constructing a bridge this big in mountains riddled with caves has particular challenges. The possibility of vast holes beneath the earth created huge problems for the designers. The physical construction of the bridge was another complex undertaking. Over 44,000 tons of steel were used to create these enormous girders. And to save time and money, project manager Mr. Zhou Daqing and his team had to use some lateral thinking to get them into place. Entire sections are bolted together on the ground and then carefully maneuvered into place. This ingenious system has revolutionised bridge building in landscapes like this. To secure the bridge itself, a cable stay design keeps it suspended from the towers. And like everything else, it's on an epic scale.
Wow, this is the muscle of this bridge. 咱们全桥的这种希拉索的钢丝，如果连成一起，应该是比北京到纽约的距离还远。哈，这么长？对，真的吗？是是是。But
this bridge doesn't just connect provinces, it connects communities. Potato farmer Liu Jiaen now has a view of the bridge from his kitchen window.
Wow. 哇，特别美。
嗯，它真个美，确实有点美。哎呀，就说我们这个地方能高高的山，主要是山高坡陡的地方，说是个直话，就这个地方一能够就夹过桥去，可是啊，这个说个直话就说，我们过去走山路然后就这个地方走上去，然后我们经常回头那个对面那个地方去，那么就说走得跑下去一个多小时，爬上去要两三个小时的爬上去，三四个小时。
The bridge here is part of a huge Chinese project to open up the mountainous southwest to the rest of the country. And as it does so, it's changing people's lives forever.